Hi, after the release of Firefox Relay and other big players releasing their email alias solution, a lot of people are wondering what's an email alias and why you should use it. So we hope to answer this question in the video. First of all, let's define an email alias. An email alias is simply a forwarding address, which means it's not really an email address, it just takes what's sent to it and forwards it to your main inbox. For example, Gmail, Outlook, Yahoo, and other important providers. The email alias on itself is not a mailbox, so it cannot receive emails. It can just take what's sent to it and send it to your real email address. At this point, you may ask, why would you need an email alias then? What's the purpose of it? There are six use cases we identified, and the first one is privacy. Email aliases can easily mask your real email address, preventing bad actors from emailing you. That's very important if you subscribe to an unsecure website or if you want to give out an email address to receive some communication, but you don't want to keep getting and receiving spam on your real email inbox. The second one is business. If you connect your own custom domain, for example, on SimpleLogin or Anonetty and other email aliases solution, you can connect it, you can use it, and you can create aliases using your domain, which means you can have your email at yourdomain.com. This can easily replace your G Suite account and other business accounts because it gives the user a way to contact you in a professional manner while you keep your Gmail, your Outlook, your Yahoo, and you don't need an actual business email. To do that, you need a reverse alias. We explain this concept and show you how to create one and send an email to a reverse alias in our latest video. We'll link it up in the description and in the meta box. The third use case is having a kill switch. When you subscribe with your real email address to something, you need to follow an unsubscribe process. For example, if you want to unsubscribe from a newsletter, they will usually ask why you're unsubscribing, they will forward you to different web pages. It's just a very, very big and complex process. But with an alias, you can just kill the alias. So we call it Killswitch. It's simply a switch in the application, it's usually in the browser extension or in your mobile application. You just disable the alias and that's it. They cannot send emails to you anymore because they don't have any other way to reach you. And you have control over the alias, which is not the same thing you can say about your mailbox, because once you subscribe to something, you need to follow an entire process to get removed from their database. Since you own the alias, you own the keys to it, and that makes it way easier to unsubscribe from newsletters, from websites, from other sorts of applications. Every time you need to unsubscribe, just click a button. The fourth use case is similar to the previous one, which is if you subscribe to a free trial, which is very, very common in the tech space, you can forget about it, you may be charged again, or you may simply not want them to continue emailing you about the free trial, about upgrading, about all of that, so you can just stop them with a click. The fifth use case is encryption. You can add PGP, which is a way to protect and encrypt your email content, to your alias. This means you can use it even when your main inbox is on Gmail, Outlook, and Yahoo, which are popular for being unsecure email inboxes. So instead of paying for a custom solution or for a custom email hosting company, just to have PGP, you can use whatever mailbox you want and still have the privacy benefit thanks to aliases. And the sixth, and not really the last, but the last of this least email alias benefit, is to fight data breach. Most companies that provide email aliasing solution also integrate with Eva being pwned, which means your email alias is constantly being scanned for breaches. If your email alias gets in a breach, you still have the kill switch, so you can just kill it, and you will also receive an email, usually, reporting the data breach. This means your email will be way more secure and you will always know who's sharing it, who has access to it, and what they can do with it. We will also link to the summary table in the description below and you will be able to find it on our website and in our newsletter tomorrow. Now let's see an example of how to use an email alias and how to kill an email alias when subscribing to a web service. For our example, let's say you want to subscribe to Wikipedia. To subscribe to Wikipedia, you can click on Create Account at the top right corner, and you will just need a username, a password, and an email address. The email address is actually not mandatory for Wikipedia, but for the sake of this example, let's put in an alias. We have our username now. We can use Bitwarden to generate a secure password. Here we go. And for the email alias, we're using SimpleLogin. SimpleLogin has this button to automatically generate a new alias, or you can create a custom one via the extension in the Chrome tab. Of course, you can use any email alias solution. SimpleLogin is not the only player in the industry, but we like to believe our software is very easy to use, and that's the only thing you need to do. You just click on the button, and that generates a new alias for you. Now let's solve the CAPTCHA, and let's create the account. As you can see, everything worked flawlessly. We now have a new account. Google Chrome is also asking us if we want to save the password. We don't want to. And here's our account. I see the inbox, everything is working correctly, just as we would see with a real mailbox. The only difference is we used an alias. And now you can see this is the alias we used on wikipedia.org. It has 1 forwards, 0 replies, and 0 blocks. Just to show you everything worked as intended, this email alias is connected to the mailbox I just opened here. And this is our welcome email. Welcome to Wikipedia, please confirm your email address. Let's click on confirm. And you will see that even when they ask for confirmation, everything will work without problems. So my email address has been verified and confirmed, but still Wikipedia does not know my real email address. They only know my alias. So if for any reason at all in the future I want to unsubscribe from Wikipedia because maybe they're sending me too many emails, or maybe I don't like it anymore, or maybe I'm not interested, I don't need to log in Wikipedia and do the entire process. I can simply click on the simple login icon or go to my main dashboard and deactivate the alias. And that's it. Wikipedia will not be able to reach me anymore because they don't have my email anymore. That forwarding email address will not work anymore. If I want to use it again in the future, I can just re-enable it and everything will start working again. But this kill switch is actually the most interesting feature of email aliases. You can enable it, disable it, and that's entirely in your control. The website cannot do anything to your alias because you have the keys to it. I hope this clarifies the concept. You can also use aliases to do a lot more if you connect your custom domain. You can see these are the free domains we offer, but you can also connect your custom one. And you can use email aliases to replace your business email. You can use email aliases to send emails, and that's linked in the description below. And in general, email aliases are just a way to declutter your inbox, give back control of your mailbox, and just gives you back your privacy, basically, which is something that's very important nowadays on the web. And you can't really do that just with your mailbox because you likely have so many emails from so many sources, and your email is also very likely part of a data breach in the past. We hope this helps, and see you in the next video.